Today we're going to talk about the DRV8825 and how to install it on the MKS Gen version 1.4. I'm going to outline a couple of things real quick here. In order to use the stepper on either the X, Y, Z, E0 or E1 ports, we have to add jumpers. So I'll show you that in just a moment, and I'll also show you how to set up or understand your stepper driver, and then how to install your motor. So in a moment, I'll show you a little bit more about the actual MKS Gen version 1.4. This is the underside of the MKS Gen version 1.4. One of the things you got to keep in mind is their pinout diagram is not very good, but they've written on the back of their card the actual positions. So the power supply is in this direction. You have the EN pin right here, then you have your direction pin right here, and your ground pin right here. So that should help you align the stepper driver board in just a moment. In a moment, I'll show you the top side of the board and how we need to prepare it. Okay, here's the top side of the board. Now, right now, we're missing our jumpers for these three pins. We want to put jumpers on them for this particular stepper driver because it adds a higher degree of resolution, so we can get 32 steps versus 16 steps for the A4988. Now, keep in mind that our enable pin is right here. And in a moment, I'll show you the DRV8825 and how we need to figure out how to set it up. Here's the top side of the DRV8825. As you can see, there is a potentiometer here that we can use to calibrate it. And then we have our cooling fins right here that cool the chip underneath. In a moment, I'll show you the underside so you know what pins exist below. Okay, as you can see, the pins that we're looking for, we have our ground pin right here, then we have our direction pin here, and then we have our enable pin right here. So this is going to allow us to line it up on the MKS Gen version 1.4, which I'll show you in just a moment. Okay, before we can actually put the stepper driver on, we need to put the jumpers on our y-axis. So I'm going to add a jumper here, then I'm going to add a jumper here, and then finally I'm going to add one last jumper so we can get our maximum degree of step. Next, I'm going to take the stepper driver and rotate it over because we know the enable pin is over here. And I'm going to place it right here and apply a little bit of thumb pressure to put it in place. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the stepper motor to the connector right here. And then finally, I'm going to connect an end stop that I've covered in previous tutorials in the playlist, so you can check that out. And that's going to be for the Y min. So in a moment, I'm going to show you how to load the Marlin firmware, but before I do that, I need to connect the USB serial cable. So the big end is going to go into the board right here, and the small end's going to go into the computer, so you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how we're going to load the firmware. Okay, the first thing you want to do is open up marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. Then we're going to open up the Marlin folder. Open up the source folder. Then we're going to open up the core folder. And we're going to open up boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to search on MKS, and as you can see, there are several, but the one we're looking for is board_MKS_gen_1.3. This can be used for both version 1.3, and it can be used for 1.4. So there's an or there. So I'm going to close out of here after I make a copy of this actual board name, and I'll show you why in a second. Then we're going to go up a directory, then another directory. We're going to double click marlin.ino for the Arduino file. Okay, now we're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. And we're going to paste what we just copied. So now it's board underscore MKS underscore gen underscore 13. Now we have to set up the stepper driver. So we need to search for A4988. And what we have here is our driver configuration. Now, if we were not to remove the comments, it would be the A4988 by default. But seeing how we're going to have mixed drivers in this particular configuration, because I want to show you what happens, we're going to remove the comments for the Y driver that we're working with. We're going to remove the comment for the X driver, and then we're going to remove it for the Z, and then we'll do E0, which is our first extruder. Now up here, it's written DRV8825 that we're going to need to use for the Y stepper. So we're going to paste it here. Next, we're going to look for max steps. Or just max, we'll say. And this is the configuration for the actual steps that occur. So we're using the Y, which has twice the actual resolution of the A4988. So we're going to take the 80 and we're going to change that to 160. That way we have, instead of 1/16th step, we have 1/32nd, which means we need twice the number of steps to move the same distance. So we're good there. So the next thing we need to do is load the firmware. So we're going to check to first see that we have the right chipset selected, which is the Mega 2560 for the MKS Gen version 1.4. And that we have a COM port selected, which we do. So we're going to click on the upload button, which will compile our changes and then upload them to the MKS Gen version 1.4. And in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, now that we have the firmware loaded, I connected the power off camera, so I'm going to plug it in. Now, be careful not to touch the board when it's energized, because it could be dangerous. So in a moment, I'm going to show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the MKS Gen version 1.4. Now we're going to move the stepper 10 units. Or 10 millimeters. So here we go. Now let's try 100. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.